Welcome back, everyone. Zeke Morgan here for an exciting long play let's play of Game of Thrones. Basically just means I will be going through the entire episode of episode 1 of Telltale's Game of Thrones. So just to give you forewarning, this will be about an hour and a 50 minute recording. Feel free to come back to it, take some breaks and everything, but me and my lovely co-op partner here,
hi,
who will be doubling as my conscience, will be going through this entirety from start to finish. I've got to say I'm quite excited for this.
I'm quite excited as well. We're both, of course, big fans of Game of Thrones. Of course, I have to point out, as your conscience, I see dark, twisted, corrupted paths in your future.
Nice. And for all of you who don't know about this, it is a Telltale game series based on the popular HBO show Game of Thrones, as the name kind of gives that away. And throughout these six episodes, we will be playing House Forrester, a noble family loyal to the Starks of Winterfell, which is quite nice.
Of course.
We will be caught up in the events surrounding the War of the Five Kings, and we'll be thrown into a maelstrom of bloody warfare, revenge, and intrigue as we fight to survive as our house.
I was going to say a bit of point out here, spoiler alert, certain parts of the game will be around key events within the story, so if you haven't watched Game of Thrones or read the books, please consider that before watching this let's play.
Okay, further to this, we will play as different members of the house, the Forrester household, and we will interact with characters from the TV series in locations such as King's Landing and the Wall. So as you said, if they don't know about it or don't know about certain events, recommend not playing it.
Winter is coming.
So, as with most Telltale games, our decisions will change the story around us, so we got to choose carefully. We can't be go around killing everyone, because when we play the Game of Thrones,
you either win or you die.
Mm-hmm. So I hope you enjoy this video, and as always, if you do, then please don't hesitate to leave a like, comment, share, or subscribe. And don't forget about my monthly Q&A and YouTube shout-out videos. So basically, if you have any questions, either about this series or any of the other content on my channel, leave it in the comment section below.
And with regards to the criteria for the monthly shout-out, you'll be leaving that information in the description below as well.
I will be.
The reason we're not going to go through it all in its entirety is, of course, we're about to jump straight into the game here as House Forrester, Lord Bannerman to the Starks, who have claim to Ironwood, which is super tough wood.
Almost impervious to flame.
Of course, because you're from the north. Oh, here we are, straight away in Tentland. You can pick this up at any B&Q or home base.
So obviously, I believe those. Oh, look, the Stark banner in the background there, and the Forrester one in the foreground. I think that's quite nice.
Forrester, of course, being a tree symbol because of the Ironwood, and the Starks, of course, the roof of Winterfell. Winterfell? I named it something different now.
Yeah, you're just making. So for this particular part, we will be playing as Garrod Tuttle. Squirtle?
Quite, yes. The Squire of House Forrester. So, of course, he's basically just up from Handmaiden and lower than Wench.
Actually, I think they're a little bit lower than Handmaiden.
Oh, okay. What about Wench?
Not too sure about that.
Well, of course, here you're cleaning a bloody sword, of course.
There's no need to do extremes. I'm just cleaning the sword. You don't need to say it's bloody, okay? The bloody sword.
Well,
I'm cleaning my master's blade. I say that as a
friend. Why is your master bloody?
I don't know.
Oh, well, you got a choice here, quite.
I will, you see.
Well, that's quite nice, you know, you can have been friendly so far, interacting with these people. Talking about the Iron Throne, of course, what everyone's in for.
Mm-hmm. Because everyone likes sitting on it. So, just to give you a little bit of the thing, those decisions that I have, I can pick whatever I want. Or I cannot say anything at all, and obviously my interactions with this will influence the game, as we've already said. So, if I called him an ass a little while ago,
As in the back end of the donkey?
Yep, of course, then maybe that would change certain aspects of the game in the future.
So you see, as the dialogue goes here, introducing here one of the main characters here, Lord Forrester, the man in the chainmail there. It's a good time to talk about Telltale Games, of course. Telltale Games made other interactive role-playing games such as The Walking Dead.
Mm-hmm.
And they use a very similar dialogue
option
which you kind of create a kind of choice between a paragon and a renegade, which you saw in other notable kind of RPGs such as Mass Effect.
Thank you,
Garrod. I'll do it. Here you are pouring wine, or has Lord Forrester just did, took the wine off because he doesn't trust you.
I believe it's pomegranate juice.
Ah, well, of course.
They're not alcoholics. It is... Well, that's invisible juice. I'm not seeing any juice there.
Of course, talking about House Tully there, who are supporters of Starks by marriage.
Wasn't that the Mormont banner there? The bear on top of the...
It was indeed, of course. Lord Mormont, of course, the Watch Commander for the Night's Watch.
Well, we hope it was anyway. If not, we're just making stuff up here. And as we can see, we're now going to be engaging in invisible juice drinking.
Probably we go grab it. Of course, Robb Stark, the King of the North, winter is coming. March on Casterly Rock, and House Forrester has been given the greatest honour to lead the Young Wolf's army and ride as the vanguard. That's not a good idea.
Well, can I stay in the camp? Can I, I think I need to clean some pots.
What are you going to call here?
I'm going to call Winter is Coming. Hey, they seem to like that.
Of course, Winter is Coming is the saying of the North for the Starks. Iron from Ice is the motto of House Forrester. Mm-hmm. Very difficult to say, I have to point out. Roderick, of course, Lord Forrester's son. It's an interesting kind of...
Well, we're really getting the history lesson for you today, aren't we?
Well, I'm your conscience.
That's good. Obviously, all these are going through my mind. Just keeping it fresh here.
Yes, my lord. So, Milud.
Love how we've pretty much, if you strap away the armour, we've pretty much...
I have to point out here, I've just noticed that your noses are very similar, and so are your chins. Maybe you're his illegitimate child. How shall
I reward? Maybe.
That's why he's being nice to his squire. Or what can I offer you? He's offering you something to keep that secret quiet.
Oh, go on, I'm gonna... Hey, don't remember that. There were those
who had their doubts. Lord Forrester, of course, remembering your positive decision there, which will help you in the long run.
No, my uncle put me forward as a squire. So my uncle obviously clearly doesn't think I can do much.
Well, I believe your uncle is actually the Castilian of the House of Forrester.
Oh, that's... So, should I be sassy and say it's longer with you? Thank you,
my lord. Well, I think you shouldn't let him down. I think you should continue to be
polite.
Polite, you don't know what's going to happen at this clear kind of gathering, drunken party of some sort. Yes, my lord. Of course, politeness there, me lord, and kind of getting nice to him now. Keep the lords happy; you don't get whipped.
Now, come on, we're riding in the vanguard, and he's pretty much just said I'm good, and that I'm going to be riding with Roderick. Can you
give me a hand? Oh, another squire's asked you to help him with his wine.
Oof. Go on. I'm trying to be nice. Let's try and be the nice guy. Who cares? I outrank you. You should help
me. Well, he's not a very nice squire.
No, that's probably why he's been sent to gather the wine.
Well, it could be worse. It could be grabbing the pots which they use for other sordid activities.
Yes, cleaning out the latrines.
I was trying to get my head out of the gutter, but nonetheless. He's a drunk liar and an arrogant prick. But shut up, Bowen. We should point out Game of Thrones, of course, is not known for its sensitivities. There's a lot of swear words in there, so if you're of a
sensitive nature,
please look away now. if there's bad language in this video, you can complain to the office of Nobody Cares.
What a best way to answer him back. Pig farmers. Who doesn't like bacon?
Vegetarians.
Well, he didn't think of that, okay? So, I'm one up on the... on the squire.
For the record, if vegetarians are watching this and they do like bacon, please let us know.
I'm gonna be sassy now.
Well, that's not nice.
Just rub it in.
You told him the truth, he'll remember you for that.
I don't care. If my uncle were Castellan, I'd be
getting promoted too. Who my uncle is? Of course, it referred to you as Sir Garrod there, of course, a slight insult about the fact of squires becoming noblemen.
Oh, okay, I really think I might have peeved him off. Maybe telling the truth isn't the best idea.
Of course, we're now looking at the twins. Of course, the Red Wedding, the infamous Red Wedding, is going on in the background with the Tullys and the Starks.
Which we won't spoil, just in case any of you, but just, this is a key aspect in the series. So,
Lord Walder Fry there, of course, if you want the spoilers for the Red Wedding, Type it into Google, I'm sure it'll come up.
All that you know is there's crossbows and swords involved, and I feel like we're going to have some kind of negative impact of it, some fallout from it.
I have to quickly point out, for product placement reasons, there's alternative search engines to Google, including Bing and Yahoo, so please feel free to use those. Don't want to be sued. Of course, we just saw some swords there and some crossbows being cocked. Cocking crossbows.
Mm-hmm.
That's not a good thing. The music is playing, the wine is flowing. Ooh, men are coming with swords. I think you should get out of here.
I definitely don't. When I'm seeing swords, I want to get out of there.
Of course, we know what happens at the Red Wedding, so I think you need to go now.
No, Bowen. We need to leave.
What's wrong with him?
I need the loo.
Bowen, we have to...
I struggled, okay?
Bowen, of course, reluctant to go. I think that's because the fact of he knows that he's been promoted.
I'm sorry. This is going to go bad.
Bowen in the neck there with a pike. He got piked. You, of course, abandoned him to kind of save your house lord. And that's going to come back and bite you in the backside. That is a... Oh, there's just mass murder all over the place here. They've never heard of the articles of hospitality, which is you don't kill someone who's had food and drink into your house.
Well, theoretically, you won't enter the house if you're in the field.
A tent is a house to some. Of course, the interactive quick time events there. Roderick, the son of Lord Forrester.
He seems pretty good.
He is quite good. He was trained by Sir Roiland, the chief military strategist.
Well, this is supposedly a gift from the king, so...
Well, that's King Joffrey, of course, not Robb Stark, because that would be a bit weird.
Yeah. King of the North is deciding he wants to punish us.
Of course, you're using your ironwood sword, a sword and shield.
What do you think a sword is? A sword isn't what goes on your arm. I don't beat people when I say that.
Well, to be fair, when I unsheath my sword, things happen. Oh, you nearly got an arrow in the eye there. This is where a good time to point out that you were once a squire, so you took an arrow to the knee.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's just nasty.
But he stabbed him in the back. Only true friends stabbed him in the front.
Of course.
Did Oscar Wilde put there as
well? Well, no, I think Oscar Wilde actually famously said you have to get down with the under the burning cart of doom there. Of course, when, for future references, ladies and gentlemen, if you're engaged in a battle during the wedding, always take cover under a flaming cart. If one's not available, horses and tents are alternative options for your hiding pleasure.
Really? Because none of that could go ever wrong. Got to avoid the fallen body there, and the guy that's trying to hit me.
And if you really want to survive...
Don't get choked out.
Well, I was going to say, get in contact with the maid of honor. Oh, here comes the horses.
It's a stallion, baby.
Giddy up. Quick time events here. So how's the quick time events? Are they quite fluid?
It's kind of weird that obviously you've got to be quite quick. Fate's going to fill that one in the morning.
I think someone should just tell me you just got run over by a runaway freight train.
There's all horses, not trains. Just point that one out.
Yeah. Oh.
That's why he did that purposely.
That's what it was. Now Roderick is dead. Or knocked out. We don't know.
He's sleeping.
You're going to have to tell Lord Forrester about that. I don't think he's going to like that.
How about now? Should I tell him now?
Well, yes. Before the maggots start taking it. Oh, that large gentleman there with the axe.
Yes.
I think you better say you tried to save him, to be perfectly honest.
I tried to save him.
I didn't
really.
There
was nothing I could do.
Well, no, but he'll kind of like that.
Maybe.
As your conscience, you have to lie here and make them believe that you're amazing.
What happened to him?
So you
I didn't leave him then?
Well, of course, you know.
I couldn't save him.
In this situation, you forget you can't save these people, so therefore you have to make them feel better.
How do you know I can't save them? You never know.
No, in the sense of you couldn't save Bowen, you got a pike in your neck, and you couldn't save Roderick, you got horse.
I might have been able to save Bowen if I wouldn't have come back to warn my liege lord, who's doing a great job of protecting me.
Well, he is, but... and there's an arrow.
You never saw that one coming.
I don't know if it was a crossbow or kind of a normal bow and arrow.
I think it'd probably be a crossbow. While there's still time. It's probably nice, because they're using Bobka's arrow, so it'll go through the armour.
Of course, you've got to get out there with your liege lord now, protect him with your life, as you go down towards the King's Road, of course the most dangerous road in Westeros.
Let's be obvious.
Oh, he suffered worse. Yes, of course, the great battle of 1975.
I don't think he suffered worse. Come on.
Oh, that's not going to be helpful.
He's not making it.
I don't think in Westeros they have a 911 or 999 to call. Where's a maester when you need one? And what should take his sword?
Clearly he doesn't like them.
You have to go.
I will do as you command, my lord.
I don't think he's going to remember that. I think some bad things are going to happen to him now that I've stolen a sword. He's got no way of protecting himself. Tell
your uncle. Potentially, but you don't know. He could be fighting this one. He could, you know, escape.
Must never be lost. So something about the North Glow.
The North Glow must not be lost. You understand? He wants you to tell your uncle and nobody else but your uncle.
Should I be like, my uncle? Who's my uncle? I forgot my uncle. My lord.
So you've given him your word, so now you've got to see if you can follow that through. We don't know what the North Grove is, we're hoping we'll find out later on, but it must not be lost.
And he said, on my honour, on the honour of my house, I've got to do this.
Yes, so here's your liege lord now fighting, and knows he's going to die, gives himself up, so you can potentially escape, assuming they don't see you now and start chasing after you, like some kind of weird black and white movie with, you know, all the jokes.
So our first trophy there, as I said, probably from doing the sub part of episode 1, and just for all of those who are interested and didn't see at the start, it is Iron from Ice is the first chapter.
Which is of course the motto of House Forrester. Now you're on the King's Road, of course, we all know what happens on the King's Road, you get robbed.
What happens on the King's Road stays on the King's Road.
I thought it was, you know, talk about the King's Road.
Well, we're both messing that one up.
Pig!
Okay, there's no need to call me names.
Outside, babe. Outside, oinkage.
Bacon.
Oh, bacon. Oh, maybe you could see his bacon. Oh, there's blood on the ground there. I don't know, maybe you should have a look at that, because there's a dead pig and blood. Maybe it came from the pig.
I don't need to be Sherlock.
Maybe one pig killed the other pig in, like, a cannibal pig movement. You know, it was Oscar the pig in the conservatory with the candlestick.
Interesting.
Upside down cart there. Maybe this is what happened. Maybe the two pigs were having a chariot race. The other one fell off and died. You never know.
Sounds good. Believable. Completely believable.
Of course, I've seen pig chariot races in my dreams. That's father's
cart. You've seen many things.
That's your father's cart there. So your father has abandoned his cart. He lost the chariot race, of course, clearly.
Mm-hmm.
Or something's going on.
So our first mention of the Lord Bolton, which has the sigil there.
Of the flayed man, which is quite good.
Lord, come on, guys!
Lord Roose Bolton, of course, the Warden of the North, appointed by King Joffrey, after he took the title from Lord Robb Stark, who's accusing Joffrey of not being the rightful King of Westeros. So, what do you do here? Do you draw your sword? Do you get to your father?
I'm going to draw my sword in the pretext that if I kill them, so? I can get to my father anyway.
I have to point out, your sword is quite bloody, so there's going to be a bit of rust there.
Well, it depends if I treat it or not.
To be fair, he's on your land, he's just killed your pig, he's beaten up your father, he's claiming it under Lord Bolton.
I'm calling that guy Bowl Hat Man.
Okay, Bold Hat? Bowl Hat, okay. Well,
bowl.
Do you think his mother would have given him the haircut?
Yeah, I think that's what the hairdressers back then did. They just put a bowl on their head and cut round it.
I believe a lot of people have had a haircut in their lives. Freud dedicated an entire chapter of psychology to it. It's called Childhood Neglect.
So he wants my sword?
I think no. Come get it, you. Well, you're not going to give it to him, are you?
Oh, okay, kind of swore a bit there.
Okay, so quick time events here. Of course, we better talk a bit about the quick time events as you engage in some kind of folly action here, trying to fight this guy.
Oh, I think he took my sword.
You've got different kind of quick times. You've got D-pad movements, and you've got buttons, so kind of square, triangle, circle, and X, as well as analog stick movements. How does that all interact? Do you find that quite difficult to switch it up? So here you've got the analog stick moving into an R2, moving into a triangle, so kind of straight then into a D-pad. So that's kind of moving the entire kind of litany of the controller. As you
that's a bit nasty.
Pitchfork him. Pitchfork farmer.
Dodge.
Do you find that easy to use, or do you think you kind of have to keep...
Dodge. I think it's okay. Obviously, I find the movement, the D-pad, kind of R2 kind of grabbing things a little bit more difficult as it normally would be.
Oh, and just as you're talking to me there, you're distracted and therefore get stabbed in the leg.
But it was quite clever though, because clearly he didn't try and go for the sword. He knew straight away that should he pick it, or should I pick it up, it'd be fine. But,
please. This guy's asking for mercy. Do you let him go? Do you kill him? You have no choice here. This will come back and bite you on the backside. He does have a family. Kill him or show him mercy?
At the last minute, I'll show him mercy.
You're being nice here. You're hoping the mercy option will help you. As your conscience, I don't think it will. I think you've made a terrible mistake here. I would have stabbed him in the neck and thrown him out with your pigs.
But our second crocodile, the Justice of Mercy, obviously making the decision there of whether or not I would kill him.
I have to point out, I don't like your straw house, your shed bungalow from other videos.
Shungalow.
Shungalow would have been much better here. Clearly this video is not going to have anything to do with crop planting, because you're not actually a farmer, you're a squire. Your sister, she hid and...
Wow, she got stabbed in the back.
We won't even talk about that one.
No, let's save all the puns for that one. But, father tried to stop them, but I think he's going to pass away now.
Your father also looks kind of slightly like an Amish man.
He is. He's the Amish elder.
Okay, that's good to know. So your kind of house has been ransacked, you've been pillaged, plundered, and...
Pardon, my sister's been, you know, the other one that goes with that. Can I pick up the enemy sword that I managed to take off him?
Probably not. Here we are now, kind of fun and games going on here, into Iron Wrath, the stronghold of House Forrester. So you're approaching Iron Wrath, where the Iron Wood is, the House of Forrester. Lord Forrester's dead.
Mm-hmm.
Roderick, the son of Lord Forrester, is dead.
Potentially.
Potentially. Your uncle is the Castilian of House Forrester's Iron Wrath. So here you are arriving home after a tremendous battle, wounded and injured. So you need a Maester, you need to help, and you need to make sure that you pass on that message to your uncle. The North Grove shall not fall, or shall not be lost.
I've got to say, the scout that spotted me on the road, he must have the best eyesight ever. Because he not only could say there's someone coming, but he also knew it was me.
Of course, nice portrait there of the House of Forrester. Of course, he went to Specsavers, you know, for his vision.
Mm-hmm.
So here you are with the Maester, who was trained, of course, at the infamous Citadel.
That's not Citadel for Mass Effect, that is Citadel training.
I have to point out, this is my favourite game in the Citadel.
Yeah.
Unacceptable. So the Maester condoling you there on the death of Lord Forrester, who you tried to help.
On the death of my family, I hope. Hopefully he remembers my family.
Okay, so we're now finding out for the first time where the bald head cut you. It's quite deep. Some will call it
vengeance. I love how he's like, I should be able to save your leg. Well, let's hope not.
The White Hills there being mentioned, of course, White Hills, infamous.
Enemies of Boltons. Enemies of House Forrester.
Yes. So the Maester should now really open your leg and kind of help it. Well, he's going for the maggot option.
Lovely. Luckily, I'm not eating. Oh, this is just going to be wrong.
This is going to be wrong, but...
Oh, really?
Okay, that's quite deep. Quite good details there. There goes the maggots. If he sews it up, of course, the maggots will eat the dead flesh. Ugh. We have to point it out here, those who like to eat maggots don't eat it after eating your dead flesh.
That's just disgusting.
As your conscience, I don't think it is. I think you're disgusting.
I love you too.
Good. Poor Roderick. So here, talking about the Forresters. We can avenge them and attack House Frey. Now is the time to find allies, not. The Maester give you some wise counsel there. Find allies and not enemies. Lord Ethan is now going to be head of the house. Lord Ethan, of course, Ethan being the son of Lord Forrester.
Mm-hmm.
Not necessarily the eldest son, which is quite an interesting one. Of course, you're just playing this game. I've already played it. So it's a bit unfortunate for you. You're about to find out kind of what's going on.
Oh, lovely. Thank you. My conscience is ahead of me for once.
Conscience is always ahead of you. You've got a very strong aura. I'm not really here.
He's as good with a sword as any man.
It's all
I've seen.
A dream.
I love how he's trying to get the information out. He's like, oh, I'm surprised he would save a squire over his son. Well, it's not my fault.
To be perfectly honest, I would save my squire over my son as well.
That's because you don't have a son, and you probably wouldn't trust your son.
Nope.
Lady Forrester will be here any moment now. I'd like you to walk for me.
Lady Forrester, of course, the wife of Lord Forrester, the deceased, is on her way, according to the Meister. You're going to be now walking about, just trying out your new leg. I mean,
it's better my septic
peg. Yep.
So I have a little bit of a walk about. Yeah, I think I can.
Of course, some medical supplies there. Are you going to? I'm not going to comment as your conscience. I don't think theft is a sensible option.
It's not. The Meister's right there. If he didn't want me to have them, he would have stopped me.
Maybe a good idea to take these, depending on what happens later on. You know what? Bandages and...
My leg may need herbs.
Branching.
Yes. I don't really want to look at that bucket.
You've got a sword, you've got some bandages, you've got some leafing materials you don't know.
Always sad to see a warrior lose a leg.
He says he seems to be suggesting there that your leg is getting better.
Mm-hmm. No. He seems to be implying that I'm going to lose it.
Of course, you're asking the Meister some questions here.
Why
now.
Why did the White Hills hit the Foresters?
We're about to find out about the White Hills here.
The feeling is mutual. There's been enmity between the two houses for as long as anyone can remember.
Oh, lovely.
I don't doubt someone killed someone, which led to more killings of
That's
someone.
That's a great history. Someone killed someone, which led to more killing of someone. And then someone like someone. Yeah.
Well, I think the key question here is the White Hills want your ironwood.
Do they really?
They take it all.
Well, they can't have it because it's ours.
The Bolton's in power, and proceed to clear cut every last inch of it until there's nothing left, just as they've done before.
So they've taken ironwood before they wanted.
Can I go now?
I believe this would be an interesting point if, of course, the Boltons come after you for
Lady
your
Forrester.
Escapades on your farm. Here comes Lady Forrester here.
Isn't that her daughter, Talia?
Talia
El Ghul? I mean. Sorry, that's Talia Forrester.
Of course, Talia there, the daughter of Lady Forrester.
As I just said.
Also, potentially your sister.
My love interest. That's what I'm going for.
Your sister, because you're the illegitimate son of Lord Forrester, I believe. Oh, sorry, I'm claiming.
Okay, you're just claiming that somehow. I think the Meister's getting it on with her.
I think the Meister takes it in the Citadel.
See, he just said, off to bed now. If he's not having it on with one of them, I'll be surprised.
The Meister's taking a vow of celibacy with his chains.
I'm sure he likes chains, but seriously, we're not trying to...
Well, you just bound your leg here, so we know the Meister's into bondage.
You saved my life, m'lady.
Yet not Roderick's.
Yeah, not Roderick's.
Oh, seriously, I'm trying to make you feel better.
I'm sure it was chaos and confusion. But if you can remember...
He fought violently.
He fought violently.
stab. I think here you should appease her, keep her happy. You never know, she may get annoyed and chop her head off.
I'm trying to. She's not showing any emotion. She'd be great at poker.
This has been so incredibly difficult.
She does awfully look like, I have to admit, here with the facial expressions. Very similar to Catelyn Stark, of course. I wonder if they kind of
faced it off then.
Yes, you know. Lady.
I don't know.
Of course, for those familiar with the TV series and, of course, the books, House Forrester isn't actually featured in these, so this is a completely fictitious house made up for this game, which is quite good, actually. It gives you a nice little depth and kind of a backstory to the Game of Thrones series that you would have heard.
I made a smile there, saying that her husband's pretty much last words to me was that he loved her.
Which is good there, of course, not telling her about the North Grove, keeping her in suspense, presenting her the family sword, which should now be Lord Ethan's by right. This should make her happy. Oh, and here comes your Uncle Duncan and Sir Roland,
I'll be sure
the head of the army.
He's doing a very bad job at it.
Duncan, this was our land. They were our people. Your family.
Talking about, of course, the death of your...
But now is the time
there.
To provoke the White Hills.
Ramsay Snow, of course, the son of Roose Bolton, the Lord. Illegitimate son, I might add.
Yep, that being known as his last name, so that's quite interesting.
Of course, because everybody born illegitimate in the North is given the term Snow, different parts of Westeros will have different last names for your legitimate children. Key point here, Snow, of course, is a very nasty man.
Yeah, we don't like...
So mentioning Ramsay, Ramsay will be here within a week, so you're going to entertain Ramsay Snow. That's going to be a problem. He's unpredictable, he's cruel,
he's crass. He's an absolute.
Yes, one of those. Cunning, diabolical, and deceitful. So you're going to have problems there. I think you need to be smart. You need to kind of be sensible here.
Need to be smart. I love how I said that with like no expression. I'm like, look, I want to kill him. But.
Mentioning there, of course, so, the famous Eddard Stark, played by Sean Bean, a fantastically good character. Ultimately, plays a critical role early on in the Game of Thrones stories. And is the man who basically set all this off.
The lord of this house, and he needs our help. It's bad enough the Boltons would have us bend the knee and swear fealty. But now, this... I'll accuse you of murder and us of protecting you.
That's an interesting point here. Of course, you did kill a Bolton man on your lands. The Boltons will see it as you have committed murder.
That's not my fault.
It may not be, but their eyes are going to see it. And with Ramsay Snow on hand, this is going to be chaos. I'm afraid it's a risk. As your conscience, I think the best thing you can do is run away.
They're going to send me to the womb.
Well, I would go as well if I was you, but...
The boy has suffered enough.
I think you should ask where you would go.
Where would you have the boy go?
The one place that's safe, beyond the reach of the Boltons.
You're sending him to the wall. The boy's done nothing wrong.
Not in the eyes of the Boltons. I'm afraid it's
the
only
choice is, do you go, do you stay?
I think that he's going to make me go anyway, so I'll say I'll go, do what's best for the house.
I think this would be much better if you kind of had a musical moment where kind of cheerleaders came in and went, should I stay or should I go now?
Be like, I'm not afraid to go to the wall.
To go to the wall.
To go to the wall now, everybody. Let's go to go to the wall now. Okay, that's enough of my musical moment.
Yeah.
what a way to liven this Let's Play up. Just lucky I'm not creating a whole song for this.
Yeah, something like that.
Did you just see our uncle disappear then?
Yes, he's a ghost.
Oh, okay, great. Very nice ghost, I gotta say.
I also heard rumours about your uncle. He's having an affair with the cook, the maid, and Lady Forrester.
Oh, brilliant.
And the horse.
That's just wrong.
I meant, and the horse, as in, look, horse, not he's having an affair with the horse. Like that's quite concerning that you think he's having an affair with your horse.
Well, that's what it sounded like. You were saying that he was having an affair with all these people, and then you named the horse. What am I meant to think?
Well, I think it was Lady Forrester in the ballroom with the horse.
Oh, quite.
A Cluedo. Of course, giving you his horse to let you ride off into the sunset to the wall. Of course, beyond the wall is the White Walkers.
Forrester asked me to give you a message.
It's time for Fill My Honour. The North Grove. Probably no one overhears this.
Explaining the North Grove can never be lost. They're fulfilling your promise to Lord Forrester. He will remember that.
Sorry.
You can't. What is the North Grove? We don't actually know. It's not often discussed, if ever.
He said, tell only you.
For good reason. Most.
What's the good reason? Know it exists.
They think it's just a myth made up by wildlings and fools.
Wildlings, of course, beyond the wall.
I assume you kept your word.
Well, he's asking you here for your honour. Did you tell anyone else?
When did I have time?
Well, you could have told the Maester, you could have told Lady Forrester, but you told no one. Of course, telling him now, he'll remember that. That's probably a good thing. He believes you can be trusted.
I should have stayed quiet and made him wonder. Be like, yes, I told everyone on my way in, including the cook. I said, cook, can I have more gruel? And remember, the North Grove cannot be lost.
Of course, Duncan has just rewarded you there, saying he may need you in the future. He now trusts you. This could happen. He's sending you to the wall, which is quite interesting. Suggesting you should become a ranger. Rangers, of course, go out and see what's beyond the wall. Maybe that's a reason to the North Grove. We don't know what the North Grove is at this stage. As you get on your horse, he's going, be gone.
But I wonder if this is going to mean that I'm going to have to swear the oath of the Night's Watch.
well, I don't know, iron from ice. Telling you here that you've upset House Forrester, that your actions of the war will reflect the house. So he's basically saying, take the oath, become the Night's Watch, but don't forget your House Forrester.
Oh, that was nice. I said, I'll make him proud. And he was like, you already have.
Your uncle is a nice man there.
Well, you can't be that nice. He's sending me to the wall.
Bandaged leg. The men are looking a bit downhearted by here. Here comes the portcullis going up. Here comes Tagliatelle, Carbonara.
Clearly, Talia, for those of you who may have remembered you forgot.
Given the necklace of House Forrester, this is where, from the Department of Makeup as you go along, comes the sponsored message that this actually is an amulet of sexual prowess. With it, you can have an affair with Lady Forrester.
That was just so unexpected then. Amulet of sexual prowess. So we have the long road ahead, so I'm going to be quite sexually frustrated, probably.
We're meeting the children now.
In the forest, so it's going to be Ethan. I think that's his sister. Obviously, Talia, who we've already known. I don't know who the boy is. Who's the boy?
The boy is Rayon, your younger sibling, son of the house. Talia, Rayon, and of course, Rayon, which is Ryan, but spelled with an O, so I'm putting a funny accent on.
Rayon.
And Ethan, the lord of the house, Lord Forrester's son, and now Lord of Iron.
Maybe something happens to him. Ethan's fine. He's just
Wrath.
Forgotten
this. I forgot what the place was called there.
You were like Iron Reach, Wrath.
Ironborn. I have to point out that I'm glad we got off the sexual comments there, because you said, oh, look, here's the children.
But at least
that's a concern.
At least you can tell that Ethan's being quite nice to his family. Made Ryan believe that he'd found me, even though clearly he didn't, because I wasn't stood behind the tree a minute ago.
Of course, you've got to be here. Asher, of course, was exiled to Essos, and their other sister is in King's Landing, handmaiden, of course, to Marjorie Tyrell. Of course, here, you've got to be nice to these people. Keep the youngsters happy. Maybe kind of pointing out here they want justification why you're sending someone to the wall.
Oh, don't tell me. I didn't send him to the wall. My uncle, the Castilian. How do you know Ethan knows he's the Lord yet?
Well, I think it's pretty obvious. When you got a nose that big.
Well, clearly.
He's got a very big nose. Of course, quite nice here that they switched these characters. Of course, you went from the Squire of Lord Forrester to Ethan the Lord. It's quite nice that they're switching these all in the first chapter. We're getting a good understanding of how the house works, who's interacting with who, who's the moral conscience here. Of course, your job here is really to make friends and not to call it. Don't know what a milksop is.
Clearly my character doesn't know.
To be fair, I think they may have said a milk shop, which is why I buy my milk. I buy it at the shop, so that makes me a milk shop.
Sounds good. Maybe it was like a typo error.
It could be. Lord should know
how to fight. Thank you, Rayon.
Of course, Rayon there telling you how Lord should fight.
With sticks. Do you remember when we
were younger? Of course.
Because sticks and stones may break my bones, but long bows will never hurt me.
Interesting here about the fact that you, her, Roderick and Ash used to play in this enclave.
I don't know.
So the Lord in training, of course, becomes more serious. She's pretty much asking you here to not do that, to become better than them. To be fair, I'd get angry as well if you banished me to Essos, which is beyond the
Narrow Sea.
The Narrow Sea, of course, the Seven Kingdoms, has many responsibilities, and all that. You don't need to be like them. It's for you really don't want to change here. You want to keep her happy. Be nice to her.
So she's going to remember what I said. Obviously, that may have an impact on the game later on down the lines. Maybe they're going to remember back to what I said, or get angry if I say the wrong thing, maybe.
Well, this is my concern here, that you said you don't really want to change. If you have to do something later quite lordly, she may see that as you changing, which is a bit unfortunate. It would be nice if someone did what I wanted. I think you should give him as many sweets as he likes.
Preserve the innocence of the youth. Protect my brother. Giving as many sweets.
course, once you've lost that innocence of youth, that's a problem. He's going to remember that, so he's going to see you as this kind of great man, Lord Ethan the Great. Summoned to the Great Hall there, you're being summoned by your kind of, I'm assuming, some kind of maid.
I thought that was Roiland.
Well, it could be weird.
Okay, let's call him my maid.
No, here's Sir Roiland. I do take that back. Lord Whitehill has arrived. He's unexpected. He's going to be like a boar, probably, you know, of course. Garrod did kill one of his men, so he's not going to be happy.
He spared the other one. He can't be that mad.
Your sister's saying, why can't they send the Castilian? Right on there, kind of asking you to stay. You've got now the choice to stay, go, or remind him who's Lord. Well, he did try to summon you, so maybe a quick sharp "I'm the Lord, go away" type thing may have a desired impact.
I'm staying with my sister.
Tell him I'm busy at the moment.
Perhaps the Lord could play games after he tends to business.
He's right.
Maybe I should have remembered that I'm the Lord, because, to be honest, if he speaks like that to me all the time, I'm going to send him away.
Well, so Roiland is going to remember that. He's going to see it's kind of, well, you don't really care, you're not really taking this seriously. He's already called you a milksop once. Maybe an appeasement is not needed here. It's going to be interesting to see how you interact with Lord Whitehill. No matter what you're going to do, I don't think he's going to be nice to you, because the fact of...
He killed his men.
Well, yes, Gower did. Duncan doesn't look happy.
That guy looks like one of the Whitehill men.
Yes.
Up unannounced. Lord White,
well, he did turn up unannounced.
I assume you explained to Lord Ethan why they...
Okay, I don't know what he's doing lathering himself up, but can Lord Whitehill, can Lord Whitehill not be a lather, please?
Or was,
Was. It makes no difference. The Whitehills were clearly in the wrong, so don't give him any satisfaction.
Well, I wouldn't give him any satisfaction in the hall anyway, myself personally.
We normally save that for the bedroom.
Yes,
come
the
on.
Swords are not sheathed.
Let's not do something rash. Things are
sorry,
bad
what?
Enough,
who's having a rash?
I can handle Lord White.
After satisfaction, you better not have a rash.
You're quite worried.
The Maester may give you cream for that.
So Duncan's obviously prescribing a bit of diplomacy there. And Roiland's pretty much saying, look,
dead men only cower. Interesting, it's coming back to Bolton here. Let's hear what Lord Whitehill's got to say.
Do you think I should greet him and be like, what's up, Lord Whitehill?
What up, me Humi?
Yeah. Come into my house. Ooh, ooh.
Lord Ethan, is it? My condolences for your father and brother.
Can I send him away, please?
It's off. Condolences. Do you shake his hand? Do you ignore his hand? Do you thank him?
I'm going to thank him.
Thank you, Lord Whitehill.
That's disrespectful.
Okay, right, he's just set the tone here. He's just basically said he has only got with that. He did stab you. I think you should just now go after him with everything you've got.
He died a hero. Let's see if I can bring this back.
Traitors and oathbreakers, there a problem there, considering this guy doesn't like you already.
Yeah, but I didn't say it was his men.
And no bread and salt! What kind of fucking house receives a lord with no fucking bread and salt? You bloody amateur. No courtesies. I should have expected it.
I think you should
calm
just...
Calm yourself.
Oh, man. Oh, the old
why did
man
he have to add bits into that? Seriously.
You foresters have shit on us for generations. Well, now the Starks are no longer around to have your back, are they? We're the power in the north now.
Roose Bolton is the warden of the north.
Sir Orlando reminding him that Roose Bolton's in charge. The White Hills may be his bannerman, but that doesn't make a difference. To be fair, I think the fat guy is probably in charge because he's had all the pies.
That's enough, Lord Whitehill.
I'm not finished.
Thought maybe I should have said Wall is Bannerman now. Sort of made him believe that I'm going to swear fealty to the Boltons.
Could be a good idea here, but this guy is bellowing at you, you know, yes.
It's billowing like a wounded boar.
Well, of course he's all over your face. Oh, here comes Ballhead.
Ballhead man, yay. Ballcut. Okay, we're going to change his name, Bolton.
Your man, the squire. We were minding our own business. Keeping the king's peace, says his lordship.
Oh, great. He's going to lie to me. He's going to lie to my face.
For
no reason.
Well, no, you actually did attack them. I have to point that one out. He is right there. He didn't say that you killed his family. Oh,
you murdered his family.
I'm going to counterject
it. It was your man who killed my men. And a pig farmer at that.
Well, that doesn't say much about your men if a pig farmer can kill them.
Well, come on. I did stab one in the throat.
He acted in your name.
Well, what do you say here? This is going to be an interesting point. Got choice. Do you defend your line?
Gun, I'm going to say they attack first.
They murdered his entire family.
You lost pig farmers, not soldiers. Soldiers worth 100 of their type.
Interesting point here. He's still going on about this.
My men. No, he's here. What have you done with him?
You did handle it, so you may as well tell him.
Took care of it. He received his punishment, and it's done.
I'm not going to tell him where he's gone. I don't want him chasing after all the kingdom trying to find my guy.
Makes sense, especially considering he's remembered your answer here. So he doesn't actually know where he is, so he can't actually go after him at this stage. He's threatening to take you to Roose Bolton here, so this is going to be interesting. The warden of the North will make the decision in this case.
A house of honourable men.
Lady Forrester getting involved here.
Oh, he looked a bit surprised there.
Lady Forrester.
You bellow like a wounded boar,
Whitehill. Ah, brilliant.
Have you forgotten your manners?
I mean no disrespect to you, my lady, considering you...
He's calmed down here at the touch of Lady Forrester.
This is not over.
Just go away.
I think you should say thank you for coming. Be sarcastic.
Thank you for coming, Lord Whitehill.
Ethan is Lord of Ironwrath now. By rights, his word is law here.
Well, can I say that we're going to take off the head of every enemy in my keep?
You probably don't have enough men for that.
Well, I'm sure I could get them in. Be like, yes, can you summon my house up, please?
Well, of course, saying now Lord Bolton, Lord Roose Bolton will have the final say. Of course, he will do as the Warden of the North.
Letting him know a Forrester man killed one of his own. That the new Lord Forrester lied to my face.
I didn't lie to his face.
Denied me my justice. Then we'll see.
Again, I've done my justice.
Of course, I think you should just call him a craven and have done with it.
Fine, okay, my conscience says it.
You'll remember that, but you said as he's walking out, I think it's quite a good thing. Now you're going to have the problem, I think, the big problem here. Boldhead, of course, looking back there, he knows what he's done. More devious than...
anything.
Than Peter Baelish.
I can't quite see whether I was defiant or used diplomacy, because... That didn't go as planned.
Well, you're kind of in the middle. Ramsay Snow coming for you to bend a knee. You've got to prepare Raven. Send it to your sister in King's Land. I hope she can interfere here. The problem you have, of course, is now you have the choice. Diplomacy, defiance. How are you going to handle this? I think your sister in King's Land is going to be the key here. All talk about King's Land, of course. Beautiful picture there of King's Land. And here comes your sister.
She has Marjorie Tyrell's favour. And Lady Marjorie's betrothal to the king may be enough to keep the Boltons at bay, if it's presented to her as it should be.
And how exactly would you bring that up? You can't really say it over dinner. Oh yes, by the way, could I just intrigue you on... I don't know. Go on, let's look at my ironwood box.
Well, personally, I would do it kind of...
What's in the box?
I would ask Lady Marjorie how her mother is, and when she says she's fine, she'll go, how's yours, and go, dead.
But my mother isn't dead.
We can kill her.
So you want me to, not only after my father's died, my uncle's died, Lady Marjorie i.e. her, her uncle.
Her, she's dead now, is she?
No, she's not dead.
It's all a dream.
But her father's dead, obviously being the Lord. Her uncle is dead, obviously being Roderick.
Roderick's her brother.
That's what I meant. Shut up. Okay, I don't want to look at anything else. Well, maybe her uncle could die. We don't know.
I'm not an expert here, but I think you're trying to kill too many people.
That's the Game of Thrones. You either live or you die.
Of course. You win or you die.
No, you'd live or you die. I'm changing it.
You're in King's Land here, the home of duplicitous behaviour.
Duplicitous, I like that.
Duplicitous behaviour, of course. Downright lying.
Everyone's going to try and stab you in the back. Just like the civil servant.
Asking for a powerful ally here, your mother's begging you to find one. So you have, of course, Cersei, Lannister, Marjorie Tyrell, the Imp, of course, is here.
Sorry, I maybe someone knocked on my door.
Maybe Peter Baelish is around. Maybe,
Littlefinger.
Of course. And maybe,
maybe the Cowboy.
The spider, the master of whispers, will be around. Cowboy, you could let him in. I occasionally invite people to my chambers. I'm
hopefully
not.
King's Landing isn't going to talk that I let a cowboy in.
I'm not quite sure you should let a cowboy in. He's, of course, fingering your bucket.
That sounded really bad.
Well, he is. Look, his fingers are all in that deep bucket. playing, and he's pulling things out.
Let's be honest. Let's get back to this.
I expected to put a rubber chicken or something. Bagark! Be nice to the coal boy. He could be a spy.
I'm going to guess. That is my initial thing. I like my in-touch football there.
Of course. Asking if you work for Lady Marjorie. I may be wrong, of course. I think you should be nice to him. I think you should just say I'm her handmaiden.
I'm her handmaiden.
We are being way too nice to this. I think I need to be more brash.
No, I think you need to be really nice to this guy.
I think I should just stab them.
You don't know, because people don't notice the coal boys or the poor. So maybe he can stab someone for you or poison someone or be useful later on, maybe sneak in someone's bedchambers. I'm not suggesting he has intercourse, but that could be happening.
Why are you telling me this?
I heard them arguing about House Forrester and...
House Forrester?
Cersei and Lady Marjorie, they're arguing about House Forrester, your house.
My house. My lovely, lovely house.
Forgive me if I was... Lady Lumps.
My Lumps. My Lumps.
My lovely Forrester.
Lumps.
See, he's saying exactly what I said, which people don't notice coal boys. They also don't notice ever pepper boys as well.
Banner brings all the boys to the yard, but they're like, we love the Starks. Damn right, we love the Starks.
What is this? Game of Thrones the musical?
Yes.
Available in any theatre near you soon.
Mm-hmm. If anyone would like to hear my remix of the Game of Thrones theme tune, then please let me know.
Ooh, ooh, arrow in the eye. Yeah.
He will not be included in this, everyone. It would just be me. I can actually hold a tune.
I can as well, but not when I'm sober.
Well, clearly. From the day you
arrived in Marjorie Tyrell there showing cleavage.
Well, she's got to, I love how we're being the chaste ones. And she's like, let me show you a little bit of...
High Garden.
my little bit of High Garden.
Of course. Betrothed to King Joffrey, Baratheon there, of course. I was about to call him Lord Joffrey, but I think you'll have my head off for that.
I think she's a spy too. Okay, so far, in a couple of minutes, I've pointed out two spies. I'm good at this.
I think that plant is a spy.
Now who's being silly?
A spider plant.
Spider plant does whatever a normal plant can't.
Gold cloaks. We gotta keep this very quiet. Gold cloaks are spies. They're the city watch here in King's Landing. Of course, the white cloaks guard the king.
Mm-hmm.
She's basically asking you, look, we need you to please Cersei Lannister. She doesn't trust you. She thinks you're basically a common... Commander. I was going to say other words there, but it's not polite. In PG-13. She demands an audience. She wants you to apologise. Will you pledge allegiance to His Majesty?
But if I do that, Marjorie may think that I'm siding with them. But what I want to do... I'm going to try and play this by ear. I'm going to try and get Cersei's suspicions off of me, pledge allegiance, if she asks, to the king, while maintaining kind of like a back alley allegiance with Marjorie. Try and get Marjorie to help me, but get Cersei to like me.
I think that's a very good idea. Queen Regent there, of course, because Joffrey is not of age to rule the kingdom yet, so he must take advice from his small council and from the Queen Regent Cersei, who's having an affair with her brother Jaime.
Spoiler alert there.
I did warn them at the start of the video.
I know, but I just thought I'd put it out there just in case.
We've probably gone through about half an hour here, 45 minutes. If you haven't worked out, there's a spoiler alert already. spoiler alert.
Spoiler alert, this game is called Game of Thrones.
Spoiler alert. Spoiler alert. That's a spoiler alert to the fact that there's going to be a spoiler alert.
Okay.
Spoiler alert. Anywho, moving on into the deep cavern, which is the Great Hall there, the Iron Throne in the background there.
With the Holy Seven Septon kind of thing there.
The Star of the Seven Kingdoms, of course. I did once hear an old rumour that when you sit on the Iron Throne, there's actually a sword which pokes upwards towards your...
backwards region.
Yes, which basically if you fall asleep, it keeps you awake.
Interesting. So on the left there we had Queen Regent Cersei. And on the right, we have the imp,
Lord Tyrion of Lannister.
They are both Lannisters. They are both Lady Marjorie trying to be helpful here, asking permission.
I think you should kneel before her. She is the Queen Regent, of course.
Yes, let's try and show some manners. Let's try and be like, okay.
The imp, of course, drinking as usual. You may rise. Very impressive. She's being sarcastic here.
House Forrester is a northern house.
Sure whether or not that was sarcasm or not.
I
wasn't
talking to you. I think it was time to talk about Cersei's garments. Wearing red there, of course, with gold. Lannister colours. Lannister always pays the debts.
He's not here. Our loyalty is. Our loyalty never wavers. See if I can appease her that way.
Oh, I'm not quite sure that would work, but maybe saying kind of Joffrey, but.
Okay. Hopefully, I was hoping she didn't bring them up.
They were our wardens.
Maybe try and get out this.
Clever girl.
Tyrion likes that.
I like that sideward glance. My answer didn't satisfy her, but she has
a talent. I'm not sure you could have, but Tyrion is playing very close game here. You're playing very clever, appeasing her. I think that must be a yes. You have no choice. He is the new warden, therefore you must serve. Yes, Your Grace. Absolutely.
I see. Despite the fact Roose Bolton allied with Walder Frey. If it was me, I'd find
right, I don't think I'm appeasing her. I'm thinking that I'm doing a very, very bad job for this.
I don't know, she may be finding it an appeasement that you're saying yes. Of course, your allegiance here must be to King Joffrey. If you are to appease her, Joffrey is her son. She had intercourse with Robert Baratheon to have Joffrey Baratheon. Or maybe it was Jaime's kid, we don't know. This is the reason the Five King War came along. Does seem rather... I think, yes, Your Grace, yes, Your is Grace. The sensible answer here.
Got to be careful. I'm not quite sure what to say. For her, obviously, with the Game of Thrones, everything you say, excuse me, can have a reoccurrence, can come back to bite you on the bottom.
Also, you can never trust the characters. Everybody's in it for themselves. I think you should say yes, everything, because that's really true.
So she'll remember that, so I'm going to guess there's going to be some kind of thing in the future.
Well, you saw the little sly smile there before she turned around. That's suggesting she just hid something that she likes and she's going to use that against you at a later date, which is quite interesting.
If I have to sleep with the house guard, I'm not going to do it. Just saying.
I'm not sure we really want to talk about sleeping with people where you don't have the medallion of sexual pleasure.
Well, that's why I'm hoping. I'm hoping my brother comes up from the womb. Oh, actually, it'll be down from the wall, but never mind.
He's your nephew.
Okay.
If you've not been following this story...
I won't judge her.
Basically, I'll tell you the quick story. Lord Forrester died. Your nephew was sent to the wall after being given the medallion of sexual pleasures. Lady Forrester is having sex with everyone, and you're about to make love to Cersei.
And I'm clearly avoiding the question.
Of course. Loyalty can be such a hard
thing to define. Well, it's not really. You can look at the Collins English Dictionary. Loyalty is in there.
I prefer the Oxford.
Well, okay, the Oxford then. Who knows what I bet she's going to ask me something about my loyalty now, whether it wavers between the king and my countrymen. You're a girl from the North here in service to Lady Marjorie. One can only assume her interests are yours.
Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question. This is a difficult one here where she's going with this. If you, of course, have the choice here, you gotta be very careful here. If you pick Marjorie, she's not going to like it. If you say the king, that's going to be a problem. I won't be conflicted, it will be a very avoidable answer. So you gotta kind of do your loyalty to the king. Marjorie is going to remember that. That's going to be a problem later on, I think. You should have just said it's not going to be conflicted, but... The most dangerous handmaiden in
all of King's Landing. Yeah, but if I said my things weren't going to be conflicted, then she could have perceived that as I'm avoiding the question again, and that I won't be conflicted because I haven't made up my mind between them.
Of course, the imp there making a joke about you being the most dangerous handmaiden in all of the Seven.
Well, you never know. I could be wielding a dagger underneath my bodice. They're ready to stab
it. Well, I was going to say the Iron Word, you know, everyone knows it's strong, tough, and hard.
Mm-hmm, just like the women.
This may come as a surprise, but I,
you know, when the medallion of sexual pleasures, Tourney of Lannisport, there, the smaller town of Castle Rock, and the banner of the Lannisters,
which is the lion, Lion of Lannister, that's their banner.
Hear me roar. Lannisters always pay their debts. Yeah, I think you should just tell him straight, look, my family is in danger, just get him outside.
I'm doing it right next to gold cloak, though.
My family fears what might happen now that the Boltons rule the north.
They must still answer to the crown. You shouldn't forget that, nor should they. That certainly took courage. To so publicly,
see, I think I should probably have asked that later on, not right next to the gold cloak.
And I think you could probably have got away with that, mention it in the front of the gold cloak's call. You just said, was you just fear what happens to the Boltons in charge. I of course found do you attempt to appease her? Do you tell him the truth? I think you should have told her the truth.
I did. I was trying to. I was trying to appease the sister.
Yes.
She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them.
Thwarting. We must find our amusement. A good word.
I was going to say, I'm not going to. I don't think naming a kid thwarting is a sensible option. Of course. Master of coin who decides such matters. Master of coin is the important one. Yeah. I think you should say he could help your family.
Let's try and get some allies here. Let's
you can help my family.
Bargain with the imp to help my family.
I suppose the crown could be persuaded to secure Ironwood from
so far. I'm playing a very dangerous game and I've been in King's Landing. I'm trying to appease Cersei. I'm trying to get on the hand with the imp. I'm hopefully going to have another choice to ask Margaery Tyrell about help for my family.
Of course, the imp here is suggesting that maybe your house of Ironwood is a good idea. He's saying, basically, are you happy to risk things for this? You are saying yes.
Absolutely.
Lord Tyrion now is going to like that. He's going to like playing this little game. Of course, I would watch out, mind you. Sansa there, Sansa Stark, who was betrothed to Joffrey until the war. Now Margaery Tyrell in charge. So far you've appeased Cersei by basically saying you'll do anything. She's going to remember that. Lady Margaery is probably going to be slightly happy that you appeased Cersei, and now here Lord Tyrion thinks that you owe him, or that you're going to do something to save your family. So realistically you're kind of doing the what I like to call the triangle, being in between two women and a man.
X wants A, but B wants C, and D just has no idea.
I was worried.
Yes.
How was it? Cersei has a way of looking.
I think you should really explain it to her. Not so great with the probably the honest answer.
Yeah, but she might be a spy.
She may not be, but she may not be. We don't know.
I'm saying she's a spy.
She probably is. I wouldn't put it past her.
Has spent the entire day working on.
She's looking at the wedding there.
Of course, you and I are seated way at the back.
Well, I wouldn't have her sat next to the king, would you?
Knife-born sons, of course, there are nine of them.
Sir Jamie.
Talking about Sir Jamie there, with the unique spelling.
Mm-hmm. Sarah, what? It's true.
Nishi's open.
And Oberyn Martell.
The Red Viper of Dawn. Got a love for Oberyn Martell.
I'm told.
Of course, he comes out and strikes.
Which I doubt
gone, let's go. He is quite handsome.
Of course.
From what I've heard. Perhaps Lady Margaery could make the right introductions. Who knows? We might meet our future husbands.
Who's she going to introduce us to? It can't really be, this is my handmaiden, please have this another king.
I was going to point out here with the Red Viper, of course, his personal guard are known as the Cobra Battalion. They strike at anything.
He does have a certain look.
This isn't the Cobra Kai.
And he's always treated Lady Margaery well.
Do you want to be queen?
For my family, I would do anything.
Front here, I just can't wait to be king.
I just can't wait to rule the Game of Thrones.
Kingdom.
I would marry him. Imagine the power.
Okay, that one I kind of said off the cuff. I tried to make something right for that, but never mind.
I shake my head disapprovingly.
Oh, great. She's actually saying if she becomes queen, I can be her handmaid, because that's such a step up.
From handmaiden to handmaid.
Yeah.
And Tyrion Lannister. Brienne of Tarth there, the man-woman, and Tyrion Lannister the imp. So interesting Bronn idea there.
So Bronn, Tyrion's kind of helper.
Sellsword.
Sellsword, yeah. Helper.
Sworn sword.
Let's apologise.
I'm sorry, me lady. My petticoat came down.
So Margaery's going to remember that my petticoat came down now that you said that.
Again, we're seeing a good view of her high garden there.
You can almost see the twins.
Of course, rising out from the from the water. To be fair, I think this conversation is going really well. I think you've got a true breast of the situation. I think two handfuls is more than enough in wine for the wedding.
I fear it will only get worse when I am queen.
Maybe they need some big cups. I'm reckoning some teacups.
I think with the
some teacups. Sorry, teacups. My mistake there, guys.
Of course, gotta make sure the teacups are supported by nice saucer sections.
Let's try and let her know that I know how to play this. Boy, had a little smile there. She appreciates my loyalty. So that's hopefully going to say to her that, look, everything I said in front of Cersei and the imp, I didn't mean. Trying to appease her, like you said.
I like the kind of scenery in the background. There's a lot of water. King's Landing is known for being moist in the summer.
There's been
of course, you've got the choice here now. What do you say to her as you're getting close? Do you ask her for help? Do you not ask her for help? I think you should ask her for help.
I think I should have waited.
I should have waited
later on down the line.
I don't know.
Wait till she's at least queen and then ask.
I do quite like to point out here Marjorie Tyrell wearing a very nice kind of dress there. I believe that's from a famous Seven Kingdoms designer.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know who it is, but I'm sure we can find out.
God, even though I think Sarah's a spy, I think I'm gonna say everything in front of her, try and find out whether she is a spy, let her know that I'm asking Marjorie for help, let them know that the God's word is probably about to be taken off us and that we need the crown to intervene.
You mean Ironwood? God's word is where the old...
Okay, I made some mistakes.
God's word is where you go to pray to the old old gods.
Oh, gods. The old gods and the new. Everybody.
Don't make me go down that route. I'll do the entire episode in that stupid voice. Of course, if you believe in the new gods, you go to the Septon.
Yeah, okay, I was going to do silly voice then.
You get the
new gods. The new gods and the old.
Of course, you have to remember when you go to the Septon that you need to get a firm grasp of the situation and ensure that you appease the gods in every way you can. I don't know what the woman was doing in the background, I just saw her head popping up and down. Hopefully nowhere near the Septon.
Please, Lady Marjorie. Beg of you.
Asking here, can she help you? Of course, you would have to appease Joffrey to do that. That could go wrong. I think you made a bad mistake here.
But I've got to stress to her how important it is.
You're adored by the king, I think, is the only way you can go with this. I think the king loves her.
I think I should have stayed quiet there. So this isn't really helpful. You don't have much time to think about it. You've got to kind of let go with your gut instincts, because obviously your silence can be perceived as other things throughout this game, as it would be for The Walking Dead.
You just have to make sure that you the decision are not kind of weighing too heavily on your mind. Got to make quick snap decisions.
I've already forgotten half my decisions.
Well, that's good. I remember them all.
Good. You know that squire at the beginning of the game, you know.
Yes,
the
Bowen,
the fat one. Don't even care about him.
Well, that's good.
He's dead. What can he do?
Okay, so here we are on the King's Road, down Wolf's Wood.
Ow!
Back to Garrod Turtle.
Tuttle.
Yes, Squirtle.
Garrod Tuttle Turtle Squirtle.
Riding your horse. Ooh, your horse is just back there like a fucking bunco.
He's gone to find my neighbours.
Neighbours.
That was terrible.
Sorry. Horse noises.
Otherwise that, it might have been scared by the wolves, you never know. So we've heard a little bit of a noise, gonna go investigate.
Of course you're on the King's Road where anything can happen.
It would have been quite interesting if they gave me the choice here to go investigate or not. But you never know.
Ah, Ramsay Snow here, of course. He's painting.
I don't think you can paint with a knife.
I think you can.
I think he's, I think he's flailing that man.
I think he's painting a Picasso. There's a bow and arrow there, of course.
Oh, I'm gonna duck back in then.
I'll duck back in there. If these people see you, you get huge chaos. This is gonna be problematic. whatever he's doing, he's getting great pleasure from.
So gotta be careful when the screen starts going red. That means that they're just about to spot you. Obviously, if they do see you, I'm guessing I'm probably going to get a crossbow in the eye.
That guy's probably dead because Ramsay Snow said that he didn't think he was ever going to end like a drowning cat.
So I do like that, because obviously the Ramsay Snow is the Ramsay's sigil is a flayed man. And I do like how he said that a naked man holds few secrets, a flayed man holds none. And we're seeing a little bit of the carnage there on the guy's arm that pretty much he has just skinned him alive.
The comment there about the fact that he didn't know his father was warden of the north means that that guy probably said something, Ramsay Snow took it offensively and used his guards to inflict the punishment. Because Ramsay Snow, of course, being duplicitous, will not do the work himself. Although I'm sure he gets great pleasure in it.
He did do the work himself. I'm going to stay. I'm going to chance it that the guy's not going to come any closer.
That's probably a good idea.
I'm thinking if I run, maybe I would have got a crossbow bolt back.
I was going to say, this would be really an appropriate time for you to pass wind or get hiccups.
I think I should jump out at them and go, surprise!
Maybe boom.
No, I'm looking more surprised.
I think you should run out there, kind of embrace Ramsay in a hug and go, Ramsay, my dear, it's been a long time since we met in King's Landing.
I'm still reckoning they'd give me the crossbow.
Yeah, but I think it'd be highly amusing nonetheless.
Or I could pretend I'm a travelling trader.
Or you can chop the tree in half, stick it on your head, and pretend you're beechwood.
Sounds good. Sounds good.
Maybe pine as well.
So they've gone down the road, and obviously, in classic fashion, I'm going to go investigate what this guy looks like.
The flayed man, of course, there. You can see you still got your kind of bandages and herbage.
And the amulet of sexual prowess.
Of course. Don't mess with the amulet of sexual prowess. Oh my god!
Can I use the bandages and take my eyes up? Because I do not want to be seeing that.
No, basically that's what happens when you use the amulet of sexual prowess.
No, that's when you use it on your own.
Yeah, too much stimulation.
Mm-hmm. So we're back now in Iron Wrath.
Of course, with Lord Ethan. And what looks to be some kind of wooden overwatch tower. Here comes Meisterman.
Most Obed Tegelin or something. I don't know how you say his name.
Aubergine.
Yes, okay, we're going to...
Meister Aubergine.
Grandmaster Aubergine, that is what we're saying.
Okay, so he's talking about the 300 generations of Forrester lords.
Who are dead, so it's not going to help.
Gareth the Tall, of course.
Thorin the Bold.
And your father, Lord Forrester.
Lord Gregor the Good.
Oh. Gregor the Good.
Do they have no originality? He
was fair. I don't know. I'm wondering what they're going to call you. Ethan the Elephant?
I want Ethan the Brave. Or Ethan the Bold. That's what I'm going to
call. I quite like the idea of Ethan the Eccentric.
No, I'm going to go Ethan the Brave. That is what I want to be known as. So I've got to try and rule my kingdom. I've got to lead it with... honesty, integrity, do everything that my father would do, try and be remembered nicely.
Oh great, so you're going to be Ethan the Earwig. Okay, great. Talking about the Lord Senator there, that's kind of like your right-hand man or woman. They're going to run your small council, they're going to provide you with help and assistance, they're going to basically be your enforcer. So if this was a mafioso, they would be your, like, kind of lieutenant.
Mm-hmm.
Your paisan.
Capo, would they be?
Oh, well, I was going to say Don, to you footing
with the Capo de Tutti Capo.
Okay, so here we go. Duncan, Sir Roland, your sister there, who you promised earlier that you weren't going to change, that you were going to be a good lord, this guy has stolen something.
My first question, I don't care. I want to know why he kicked that man.
This craven is a deserter and a thief.
So, a deserter and a thief.
Oh, well, it looks pretty good for a deserter and a thief. Thanks for saying that, mate. I don't like you anymore.
Fucking know it!
Stop hitting the prisoner!
You're gonna hit them.
No!
And so Eric here, with a K, stole weaponry and stole food.
Let's ask him just to make sure.
Yes, my lord. I fled. We should all flee.
It's not stealing if you're taking what's yours by right.
How is my weapons yours?
They're not two coins to rub together since Lord Gregor left us to rot here. Where's our pay?
Lord Gregor went to help the Starks. Okay, I'm not going to tell Sir Roiland off for that one. He deserved a good slap up the head.
Lord Ethan, I know these words are hard, but they're honest. This house is falling. We'll never survive the coming winter.
Together we'll survive. Let's try and get some...
You say that, but it won't be you who's starving come winter.
Talking about, of course, the Lord gets all the food. So Roland quite enjoys beating people.
I think he does. I think he has more muscles than brains.
You must decide the punishment. Lord Gregor always took a thief's finger.
People are asking there, you can hear people shouting in the background. Kill him, send him to the wall, let him go. You've got a choice here, realistically. If you're going to punish him, are you going to be harsh or are you not? And how are you going to handle this situation? Because the people watching, your sister's watching, this will depend and determine your kingdom massively. I think personally, the thief by definition, kind of the Victorian era, where this game is kind of realistically set, did have fingers chopped off.
An innocent man will be an injustice, my lord.
You're not innocent. You admitted you did it. I don't want to send you to the wall because that's a bit of a harsh punishment, but I can't let you get away with it. So I'm sorry. I'm going to have to take your fingers. I name you a thief. You are a vagabond. You're dishonest. And your punishment, I'm going to take three of your fingers because that's completely right. Can I do like every other finger? I think that would be pretty cool. But as because I was the one who did it, hopefully they let me do it. I did do it, so of course the one who passes the judgment must swing the sword, but I think I'm going to be taking a hatchet by this chance.
A lesson learnt from Eddard Stark there.
Oh, so I'm really sorry about this. Please don't let me show it. Oh, no. Okay, I'm going to actually have to cut his hand off.
Oh, that's nasty. Although, point here, he can have them sewed back on.
I don't think they'll really remember that. My house will remember the judgment, so they could find me just like my father. They could find me a little bit too brash. Hopefully they're going to go see the maester now, but I somehow doubt it.
Your father was called Gregor the Good. Of course, trophy there for making that decision.
That was certainly unpleasant.
You've still got to pick your sentinel.
The Lord must have punishment when it's due.
So it's been interesting. The maester's talking to you here. He's just wondering, kind of...
did what I had to do, and it didn't bother me.
Try and surprise the maester.
I expect this sort of thing will happen again, but a sentinel can help you in the face of disloyalty. You need someone you can trust.
Okay, maester. Can I pick my younger brother?
Someone you can rely on. No matter the
Well, you're right on there playing around with a sword. Your sister's tending to the horses.
People should know that too many voices.
Talking about the small council there. That you need to pick a sentinel. This is going to be an interesting point here.
Be one advisor above the, rest.
The one advisor to rule them all is like a kind of ring.
They both want the job,
but neither likes the other. Obviously, I've already annoyed Sir Roiland already, saying again that I was going to stay with my family in the woods and not coming straight away as he called. I'm going to get the bracer of the sentinel, so hopefully someone will wear that with pride. I think that's a quite nice intricate design. I think if I was going to wear anything like that, I would probably feel quite happy wearing that.
Well, as we know, kind of from King's Landing, whereby Lord Ethan's sister was talking to Margaery, as we said there, same situation here. You really need someone who can get abreast of the situation, take full control of it. Who you decide is going to have an impact. He's basically saying, come see me when you can reconvene the small council. So this gives you the opportunity to kind of explore the area, talk to different people, get their advice. So Roiland there, Duncan in the corner. There's Duncan next to the flayed pig. He's making pork chops for later.
Everyone's obviously looking at it. They want to know what's going to happen. I don't really... Can I take that? No.
Are you going to talk to your siblings?
I'm going to talk to Ryan. Sorry if I say Rion.
Rion.
Look at this. All good swords have a name. I call them. Oh, that's nice. Two brothers. I carved this to give me
strength. Oh, that's nice. So
oh, that's brilliant. That's so sweet.
Roderick would be proud. You're honored.
I was going to say I'm honored.
You honor Roderick with this. He was a strong one.
He was.
Okay, he seems a bit sad for that.
Yeah.
But, can so I add on to that?
I'll have a real one, but not like that one. Only a lord could have that sword.
No, that isn't my house sword, though.
I'm sure of it.
Who's still got my house sword?
It'd be in the Great Kingdom.
Great Keeper.
I saw what you did to that
the
man.
Horn. This is actually quite nice. I have to point out, I do quite like this interaction here. Ethan and Ryan. It's quite nice, kind of family. It kind of humanizes the character, which is quite good.
Obviously, he was wondering whether he was the enemy. I have to kind of let him know that. Okay, fair enough. He believes that he was bad. Probably saying that I should have done something worse to him.
He's talking about his wood there. At that age, you know, it can be quite confusing. You know, you see men floating about and you've just got wood. I think you should really explore some more here. Maybe if your sister's around, maybe talking to her would be a good idea. Get her views on things.
Don't think I can talk to my sister.
Malcolm.
Don't know who Malcolm is, but he looks like he's in the middle.
I believe Malcolm is your
stable hand.
Uncle. Who is your mother's brother. So he's Malcolm of No Nam.
No Nam.
No Nam.
Malcolm No Name.
It's a place beyond the No Nam. So Lady Foster is a wall wench. He's probably having intercourse with your handmaiden. As I just nearly injured myself, it was the amulet of sexual prowess.
So already he's just said that my mother has sent him off to get Asher, even though I'm the Lord, I should be making these decisions.
Of course, this is an interesting point. Asher, of course, in Essos, beyond the Now Sea, he could come back. This could have an impact. If he comes back and he's completely delusional, he may kill everyone, or he may help you.
So I'm not going to try and sugarcoat it. I'm trying to let him know that got to be careful. But I am the Lord. My mother can't be making these decisions. It's going to have to be me.
Well, you know, if I may be so bold, he's suggesting that Sir Roiland here should be in.
Why Sir Roiland?
We are at war. You need a warrior by your side. Roiland has the respect of his men and will bring strength and discipline to this house. Duncan would offer sage advice, but now is not the time to negotiate. Not with the likes of Ramsay Snow.
Thank you, Uncle.
But the only issue, Ethan, sometimes diplomacy is the best thing, as they say. Sometimes the best offense is the good defense. Maybe that's what's going to happen.
Here, talking to your sister.
Mira has asked for Lady Marjorie's help.
Did she?
I knew we could rely on Mira.
Well, I wouldn't say that. You never know what's going to happen. Don't know if Lady Marjorie's influence will be enough. Don't know if it's going to sway the king or whether or not that's just going to get me in even more trouble.
I think it's quite interesting here that you don't really like Sir Roiland, favouring Duncan at the moment, but your uncle just said Sir Roiland may be the best option.
She thinks I'm cruel.
He left me. I think you kind of.
You have to. He left me no choice. I'm gonna.
Always have choices.
Ah, thank you.
I know you said you'd get angry sometimes, but I didn't think I'd see it so soon.
I can't afford any more mistakes. Everyone knows what happened.
So that's not the best thing. I'm trying to keep my family close, my enemies closer.
I know.
But unfortunately,
that wasn't your fault.
That just kind of failed with Talia. I think maybe I should have chosen a different option there. As my conscience, what do you think?
I think you kind of made a mistake, but at the end of the day, you did warn her early on that you may get angry, so it pretty counters it, balances it. I think you should ask her who should be sentinel.
Tell me.
Now I'm going to ask her, what would you do?
You must be strong, decisive. You
are trying to bring it back to her, try and let her know that I'm asking for her sound advice.
Just as capable as Asher or Roderick ever were.
Oh, that was quite nice of her to say, because Asher's the more warrior one, as you've said a couple of times, he's been exiled. But Roderick fallen in battle to save other people of our house, but really just a horse fell on him. But never mind, we'll pretend he's this great hero.
She's now going off. Without giving you some information about who should be in charge here. You know, talking to Sir Roiland here.
Swing left! Sorry! Wrong! I didn't know
that.
Well,
he is nice.
Of course, my lord.
Well, you better be okay to have a word with me. I'm the bloomin' lord.
And I wanted your advice.
How are our defences? Let's ask about this.
Are these men ready for what's coming?
This lot, ready? No, for this. We post anyone who can hold a spear along the parapet, up where they won't get much scrutiny.
and put our meanest, nastiest-looking brutes front and centre.
That makes sense as a Vega strategy there. Stick your weaklings on the wall, you are more likely not to kind of be noticed. The problem you have here is, do you trust Sir Roiland?
And you should know that swinging that blade yourself took stones. It was a man's way of justice.
Okay, so I'm probably getting some points there for Sir Roiland. I'm not going to be giving him the bracer. I do want to speak to my other potential sentinel. Duncan? We like Duncan, don't we?
Yes, my lord.
Well, you like Duncan, I don't, but...
Oh, that's nice, I love you too.
It's a difficult decision.
Perhaps I can
help. I think Duncan's a bit of a kind of muppet, but...
that's lovely. Let's ask him a little bit about the sentinels. I'm not too sure about them.
And if I may ask, who do you favour for the role?
I'm not telling you that.
Well, it depends. If you want him, why don't you ask, would he consider it?
Ah, I ran out of time there. Just as I clicked the button, I kind of stayed silent. that's one way of me getting out of it.
Maybe you can't talk to him again, but you can give him the bracer, making him sentinel. Maybe there's some food over there. Maybe fooding would be good.
Let's go talk to the Meister. Let him know that I have made my decision. I'm going to be naming my sentinel, as he said. We give it at the small council, so there's going to be no point me giving it to one or the other of them now.
Okay, so you're prepared to name your sentinel. You have a decision in mind. You're now speaking to Lord Origami. Meister Origami.
I thought you said that was Meister Aubergine.
He changes his name. He folds himself into every position.
Okay, this isn't the Kama Sutra.
It's not known. You get that with the prowess.
Or is this Gama Sutra?
It's Gama Sutra.
Interesting. So now we're going into the Great Hall.
Right, you're going into the
fingers
hall.
Crossed.
Maybe
not. We're going to have a little bit of gear cogs.
Yep, here we are. Into the hall.
They already sat down. How did they get in before me?
Ghosts.
Oh, okay then.
One rode a unicorn. Of course, your small council here, Meister, to provide you with medical advice. Sir Roland, military advice. Duncan, because Duncan provides any advice. And Lady Forrester, because she is technically
before
in charge.
I name my sentinel,
well, we really need our mother here, just in case. Let's try and appease Roiland. Them, say that this they were both worthy of both. It, but I have to make a clear decision.
I was going to say, you really do need your mother there, just in case you get hungry.
I love how he literally just said, you can only choose one. I'm trying to appease them, Meister.
But I have made my decision.
Oh, they're both going to be leaning in now. Eeny, meeny... Oh, can I pick my mother? No, I can't. Duncan? Duncan Tuttle, my uncle, you will be my sentinel.
Okay, so decide, Duncan. I personally myself would have picked Sir Roiland. Yes, it's a controversial decision. You don't particularly like him, so you have to pick who you trust. But I think it's a problem. You haven't picked the military strategist.
So Lord's disputes, now they're probably going to be fighting over it. That may come back to bite me. Maybe... Mr. Tuttle will require diplomacy a bit. Let's try and say we'll deal with them, prepare for the worst, devise a plan.
I was going to say, if you get Ramsay Snow's 2 days out now, he is a problem. You just decide not to listen to your military team. Pick a strong military leader, that could have a problem here. He, Duncan, of course, advocating as he always has, sage advice and diplomacy, so Roiland going further with the military strategy. What do you do here?
Lord Ethan deserves to hear from all of us.
Enough! Would my father have stood for this kind of bickering? Neither will I.
Ethan's quite a...
Sir Roiland is clear.
Well, yes, as they decide here to argue, I think it's a good time to talk about kind of the aesthetics of the game. Quite visually stunning game here. The cartoonish graphics is actually working quite well. Makes the character stand out more. Also, each area seems quite different. So when you were in King's Landing, you could tell it was more open, light and airy, whereas this is more kind of dark, grungy and kind of disturbed because it's in the north, it's cold. The clothing is also different as well. More kind of airy fairy clothing in King's Landing, more kind of woolen clothing here. What do you think? Do you think the kind of visuals are good, or do you think realistically you won't notice them if they weren't here?
No, I definitely think the visual aesthetics make up for it. As the first game that I ever came across on this, The Walking Dead, Telltale version of it, that was quite aesthetically pleasing. And I did say to you as soon as that came out that I thought that later on down the line they should make a Game of Thrones for it. I'm definitely thinking favorite diplomacy over this, just getting back to the game. But I think the aesthetics really make it up to it. They bring out the characters, you, as you mentioned, have that nice little contrast of areas.
Of course, you know, we have got 6 episodes in this series, haven't we? This is only episode 1.
Which we're still not all the way through yet, so this is going to be a quite long video, obviously, as we said at the start, but we will play to the end and let you know how it all goes.
Well, yes, I'm hoping the amulet of sexual prowess will be used to good effect.
Maybe that will happen when I'm at the wall.
It's an interesting choice here. How do we set the stage? Ramsay's arrival. Do you meet him in the Great Hall like a lord? Or do you hold him back and stick him behind the portcullis?
Ramsay Snow is no lord. That's absurd. You meet him at the gate with as much force as we can muster. Make him wait. Let him gaze upon Ironwrath. And when he enters, he'll know it's only because you allowed it.
Okay, they're both making very good decisions there. Though I'm going to see if I can appease Lord Ramsay, invite him into the gates, try and get on his good side straight away, let him know that I do see him as a lord, I do see him as my equal.
So Roland, they're saying that your new sentinel is steering you in the wrong direction here. Ramsay Snow, of course, is not a lord. He may be the son of Roose Bolton, the Warden of the North, and may claim a lord title, but he's not actually a lord. So Roland, they're saying you may ask him to sit down, I'd probably be the best option. Okay, you've decided to go against your conscience and tell Sir Roland to get out. Sir Roland saying you'll regret that, saying you're not ready to be Lord. That could be a problem considering he's in charge of the military.
Yes, but I can't have him bickering, standing up and kind of devaluing me in front of my small council.
Maybe Lady Forrester will be the good point here.
Meet Ramsay Snow in the Great Hall.
Meeting Ramsay Snow in the Great Hall may not be a point. Not saying that you shouldn't offer any of your iron wood. You may have no choice. You may have to negotiate it.
We should adjourn. We have to prepare the house.
As I've said a couple of times prior to this, I do believe I made probably the wrong choice. Saying to
there will always be those who question
Roland then to get out. Maybe he might see that as a slight on his honour. Slight on his virtue. I think maybe I should have said either be quiet or sit down. Sit down probably being the most less Asher. Offensive one of that.
Your mother there mentioned it. Asher, we know Malcolm told you about it.
What's more,
so yes, the will to fight, hunger for it. That may get me in a little bit of trouble. It may not. I'm going to say that
I hear what you're saying.
Of course, bringing Asher back from Essos may be a problem. We're about to find out about Asher's backstory here.
But your father said Ethan must fight his own battles. But when Asher saw it, he didn't take a breath. He grabbed the miller's boy by the neck.
So a miller's boy, of course, was interacting with you, picked on you a bit, Asher stepped in. So he's been the protective bigger brother.
There's protecting me and there's knocking half the poor boy's teeth out.
Yes,
that's a little bit too.
The problem we have, of course, if Asher comes back, does he become Lord? We don't know. That's
but just think, if Sir Roiland comes in, I mean, if Asher comes in and Sir Roiland goes, I can then make Asher the head of my military. We know he has a thirst for violence. There we go, give him a nice position.
Potentially an option here. Malcolm's turned
up. Hi, Malcolm.
I think you are going to get the option. Do you send him or do you not? Should he stay or should he go now?
Let me send Malcolm.
You and your singing today, I swear.
It's not my fault, okay?
Send Malcolm to Essos.
Malcolm will go to Essos.
Send him away.
On a jet plane.
See, Ego, you just completed that then, not me.
Thank you, Ethan.
Don't even look at me for that one.
They don't have planes in the Game of Thrones.
Never know, they could be hiding them.
They have dragons. They fly away on dragon planes.
Fly away now on my dragon. Okay, that's all I got.
That's all you got.
Give me till next episode, I'll have something.
Yes, I'm sure you won't.
Fly away now on my dragon.
Oh, what, here we
take
are.
Take me by the inn so I can get my flagons.
Oh, what, I put out. Wait, back to the Red Keep, back to the grapes. That's a lovely bunch of grapes, I see.
Ooh,
what, Tyrell stamp there. Do you keep it? Do you pick it up? I think you should take it. Potentially be used at a later stage to forge a letter. Of course, you're in Lady Marjorie's chambers. You have gone beyond the door.
Wouldn't be the first time.
You've taken a you've taken a mysterious key, which we don't know what that's for.
Where'd that go?
That could be a problem later on. It's a strange key. It could be used to unlock a chest or a chastity belt. A stamp there, of course, of the house. If she becomes queen, maybe you could forge her signature. The other handmaidens turned up there looking a bit distressed.
I want to help you if there's anything I can.
Saying
do.
She wants to help you? I think you should believe her. I think you should thank her for her offer.
Thank you.
I love how you're picking some of the options I would do, yet we've already had a little bit of a moral dilemma, moral conscious dilemma of some things that you would pick that I wouldn't. Lady Marjorie is back.
She doesn't look happy.
She definitely doesn't look happy. I think things may have gone a bit wrong for it.
Well, I think she's missing a big chunk of her dress there in the back.
That was already like that.
That's what they all say.
That's called...
Do you ask her... well, yes, probably not asking to have Joffrey is probably not a good idea.
No, clearly. Let her know that I'm there for her. Let her know that I care.
The king was not inclined to offer help for your family.
The king wasn't happy.
She's got a little bit of a torn dress there.
I don't know how...
She's got a little bit of a bruise there as well on her face. I'm just by the side of her...
And he reminded me that I am
cheekbone
not
there.
His wife.
No, that's too much blushing.
Oh, quite. She allayed his fear, but obviously, that's probably going to come back and bite me.
Nothing I said cheer him.
Maybe apologising?
No, I'm going to say, what can I do to make it better? I think that works a little bit more than an apology, and as you can see, she did appreciate
understand,
that.
It was my mother's not mine.
Okay, that I wouldn't have said. I wouldn't have tried to push it onto my mother.
So Joffrey is not going to help you here. You may need to use Cersei or Tywin,
Tyrion.
Or Tyrion. Well, I was going for the entire Lannisters, of course. Tywin, of course, being the father of Cersei and
Jaime
and the Imp. So therefore, you may use him. You know, played by Charles Dance, the famous British actor.
I like him. He makes the Game of Thrones. I think he plays a very pompous kind of guy, but it's good for his character.
Of course. Now you've gone beyond. Outside the bedchambers.
Can I lock the door?
Your call boy's back. He called you me lady.
Begging your pardon, lady.
Let's be nice.
I hope I didn't frighten you.
I'm not quite sure whether I'm being nice to people or not. I'm just trying to make them all work for me. So get the call boy on side, he can be
right
my
before.
Kind of spy.
Lady Marjorie and Queen
spy.
Cersei.
Well, hopefully so.
I just want you to know.
I just noticed this, and I don't know if there's anything to do with the choices you've made, but certain writing is in certain colours. So for example, white writing here for the choices, and then certain interactions, as you can see here, blue writing. I don't know whether or not that's an indication of whether or not, you know, they trust you or hate you. Interesting to see that later on in the game.
Unless they give every particular character that you do a different colour. So notice I normally speak in white, and then most people come back in a different colour.
Well, that's what I was just noticing. So I'd be interested to see that. I'll probably look out for that during the Ramsay Snow argument. He's run away, so there's some gold cloaks back now.
That's the guy that opened the door for me.
Why, yes, he gets around a bit. He makes his way through King's Landing. As you kind of run away into the pit of despair, past the gold cloak, who is thinking to himself, you just came from our bedchambers. Wonder what you were doing. Kind of quick loading screen here now, and you will be heading straight back into the Forrester household to await the arrival of Ramsay Snow. Sir Roland, your chief military advisor is not there. Valley's pride more than honour. You must do this without him.
So I probably have slighted him. Probably hurt his pride, wounded his pride. Hopefully that isn't going to... I hope so. Hopefully we've done enough. Duncan did notice that. Maybe I should have. Probably.
Lord Whitehill there and Ramsay Snow, of course, King's Landing are not going to help you. You have not secured the help of King's Landing. Ramsay Snow making jokes now about your wood.
Mm-hmm.
Iron wood is near impervious to flame, my lord.
Mention iron wood there, impervious to flame, of course.
Is it?
So that's quite nice. That's going to be interesting. Introducing Lord Ramsay of House Bolton, son of Roose Bolton,
Warden of the North.
And here we go. That's going to anger him a little bit.
Oh, interesting. Lud Whitehill there making a stupid comment. I would never have said that.
Who is this little boy?
Maybe offering him bread and salt or.
Lord Ramsay, welcome to.
No, let's make the same mistake twice. Let's not offer bread and salt. There we go. So blue writing. Oh my God,
blue writing there. Just keep watching to see if that does change because I want to see whether or not.
Yeah, yellowish kind of tint for him then.
Yep, iron wood there. Ramsay Snow inspecting your wood.
Iron wood.
No one can match your skills. Probably a good option. Making believe you that you got the best skill. Because we of course know that the White Hills want ironwood.
Oh,
Ramsay Snow showing a bit of violence there, unexpected violence. Interesting there that he's already shown he's unpredictable. Mentioning to Lord Whitehill, giving enough time he can do that. He doesn't trust Whitehill by the looks of things.
But come on, if we've had the ironwood, we haven't squandered our share of it. We're still making those intricate designs with the craftsmen. I can't really say much. Now he's going to start my family. I've got to be careful here. May have to intervene.
Roy on there, coming out, slightly hiding behind his mother. Really, I think you should say, look.
What do you want, Lord Snow? Lord Ramsay, sorry, I can't say Lord Snow.
That gets his attention, which is good. Get away from your family. Keep your family safe. That's the key here. He wants you to bend the knee to Lord Bolton, Warden of the North. You have no choice but to really do that. If you don't do it, it's going to be chaos.
Words are wind. Anyone can say they're loyal.
Okay, I'm gonna nail. I was tempted not to, but let's try and get him on side. Try and show him that I am, for the most part, loyal to his family, even though I don't think I should do. I think I should really grab a dagger and stab him copious amounts of time in the eye, but never mind.
Key point here, the crown wants what you've got. They want your ironwood. The crown is more important. The crown can overrule the Warden of the North and Ramsay Snow. They want your ironwood. So we need to remember that.
My father's promised as much to the king. So again, let's try and appease him. Let's try and say, we'll double our efforts. Let him know that we're there looking out for him. Trying to make as much as we can for him.
Refer to you as a little lord there, trying to belittle you a tiny bit. Lord Whitehill, noticing this is going bad for him, is trying to push this back. Whitehill has lied to you, is probably the option I would go with. He has lied.
I was going to say he was justified, but let him know that it's not how it is.
A liar? He's a Whitehill.
Okay, that clearly.
Me into your hall like a proper lord, hoping I wouldn't linger outside long enough to notice your.
Oh, come on, Ramsay. You can't hold that against me. If I would have left you outside, you'd have been angry that clearly I didn't invite you inside.
So I've come up with a solution that will benefit everyone.
Okay, this can't be good.
The Whitehills will be taking control of your ironwood from this day forward.
I would argue this way. He's just saying they've taken all of it.
But
that is our livelihood.
Then you'd better well find another fucking job.
You can't do that.
Why not? You know something the Whitehills don't?
I think here you should say Whitehills will ruin the forest. No, we are the true craftsmen, would probably be the best option actually. Make them believe, as you were saying, that is probably going to help.
Do you want ironwood for the next 5 years? Or the next 50?
That was a good option, I believe. Hopefully, he heard my arguments, that was good.
We'll try this. Lord Whitehill.
Oh, thank God, he's not taking it all. He's only taken half. I suppose that's a little bit better, obviously.
Well, that's better because that gives you the opportunity now, specifically kind of with King's Landing. You've got the stamp of Marjorie Tyrell, you've got Cersei, you've got Tyrion. Maybe you can convince him to get the other half back. Half is better than all.
He is stationing men here. We can't abide Obviously, it's going to go down. Well,
and make
sure it will cause you more trouble than...
This will cause more trouble, not less.
Not for me.
Oh, he seems way too happy to gloat there.
Of course, 20 Whitehill men staying in the town, that could be a problem. Your army could probably mitigate that, but that's going to be an issue.
My son, Griff.
Griff, his son is going to lead the garrison. So Whitehill's son is leading the garrison. That's a point.
Oh my god, Duncan, take your hand off your sword, please.
Do make this visit.
Please, take your hand off your sword, Duncan.
Duncan, don't.
Lady Foster, they're saying, look, don't get involved.
Look at this little forester.
Okay, he's picking on Ryan.
Seriously, Ramsay, get away from my family, please. I don't like Ramsay.
Well, I'd be more concerned about the fact that he's picking on your brother yet and hasn't... Oh, he's your senior sister.
I'm his twin, my lord.
Oh, she's my twin.
Like the queen and her brother.
So obviously the little jest there about Queen Cersei and Jaime Lannister. Or the Queen Regent, Cersei, shall I say.
Yes, and Lannister. We have more to discuss or
we have
enough?
More to discuss, Lord Snow.
I love how I said that a little bit.
You can be with me. You can be my highborn ward.
No, she's not.
Well, Duncan can't intervene here. That's a problem.
She's quite pretty.
Take me instead. I'm going to sacrifice myself for my sister and try and let him know that he can have the Lord of House Forrester instead of just my sister.
It's an interesting point. You
protected
your sister.
It's been quite nice.
I think that's a mistake.
Oh, what? What?
What have you done?
Okay. Ramsay Snow there just completely threw things out of whack there, killing Ethan Forrester, or the Lord, in the Great Hall. He bent the knee. He did everything he could have done. We're in serious trouble here. We need a Meister now. Somebody better go and get the Meister. Ethan is in serious trouble. There's very little chance he could survive of that. And Rhaegar now being taken hostage by Lud Whitehill at the orders of Ramsay Snow. Ramsay Snow bowing there in a sarcastic manner as he leaves, causing chaos, carnage, and blood in his ways. Fetch the Meister. This is not going to be good. Ethan is potentially dead. Ryan's on his way off with the Whitehills, and 20 Whitehill men are stationed in your house. What is going through your mind right now?
That I'm dying.
Ethan Foster is now dead.
So that's a lovely Lord's reception there, and that concludes the first episode. We're going to have a little bit of a prelude to Game of Thrones Chapter 2, which, again, like this video, will be a long play of it. So if you did happen to like this,
Ethan
please stay
sacrificed
tuned for that.
Himself for us all. He saved Talia's life. He'll be remembered as Ethan the Brave.
Yeah, I got my title.
This house needs a leader.
Lord Ethan named me Sentinel. I will lead this house.
My sister asked you to swear loyalty to her son, and you did it without flinching.
We can't let them hurt Ryan too. We have to stop them.
We do not stand alone. There are those who will fight for us. Those who hold House Forrester above all other loyalties.
Those
who will John
not
Snow,
stop
of course.
Until Ethan is avenged.
Oh, that looks like...
Until Ryan is home again.
There's Asher of Essos. So, of course, this is an interlude and prelude to our next episode, episode 2. Of course, you've got to stay tuned to watch that to catch the next Let's Play series.
On the next episode of the Let's Play
series of Game of Thrones. There you are, you've got the trophy for Squire. You, of course, playing this offline, which is good. Some credits here.
So, thank you very much for watching that. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as we have, or I have playing it, and you have being my very nice conscience there. As always, as I said at the beginning, if you do like this, then please don't hesitate to leave a like, comment, share, and subscribe. And please let me know what you think of it. Failing that, please don't hesitate to keep an eye out for episode 2.
And remember, ladies and gentlemen, until next time, when you play the Game of Thrones, you either win or you die. Bye for now.
Bye for now, and we'll see you soon.